就是我不能说是用什么东西发过来的，就是有人给我发了个信息，然后我打开一看，是上面是有政府机密，怎么出来的？我就很恐怖。
但是你收到的时候，你的感觉为什么这么恐怖？
不好意思 ，sorry。
Since 2017, China has rounded up over 1 million Muslim Uyghurs into so-called re-education camps. Beijing claims these are voluntary training centers designed to combat religious extremism. Asia Abdullaheb is working to disprove that narrative by sharing a number of secret documents coming from her homeland, Xinjiang. We met Asia and her ex-husband, Jasur, to talk about a new leak. A document that reveals for the first time records of over 300 individuals, all of who have been detained in camps.
这个文件是有关和田一个县里边的被抓的人员，其中就是有些人被释放，但是还是在控制当中，而且也包括他们在国外的亲戚，和他们的就是。具体的详细的个人信息。最恐怖的是他们的圈子，每一个人全部卷入，只要那么发现一个人，就是他的那个朋友邻居都可以受到牵连。
细节很多，
细节非常多。
The document is titled Trainees Whose Relatives Went Abroad and Did Not Return. It lists the specific reasons for each person's incarceration in the campsThings like wearing a headscarf, applying for a passport, or even going on a foreign website. Another column lists detailed information about their social circles and three generations of family members. All of that information factors into whether or not they're eligible for release. The Chinese government did not respond to our request for comment. Jasur claims that Chinese security agents tried to prevent documents that had been leaked to Asia from getting out.
就是当他提起阿西亚的名字，我想的当时就是这种事情就是100%就是他们，中国政府。
In September 2019, Jasur says he was lured on a trip to Dubai through a close childhood friend, who said he needed to meet him urgently. When he landed, several Uyghur and Han Chinese intelligence officers were waiting for him.
给你一个 U 盘，你就把这 U 盘插到阿西亚的电脑上面就可以。这个文件在我们全部被一个人给泄露出去了。他们的目的就是，如果我插了这个 USB cable， 他们就是通过这个 cable 去抓他谁来泄露的这个人，就是完了以后就把一个 U 盘插到了他们电脑里面，有我母亲的视频。
你觉得他们为什么要你看你的妈妈的视频？
这就100%就是威胁，让我去干这种事情。如果我干了，我妈妈会安全，我姐姐哥哥都会安全。
We're unable to independently verify Jasur's claims, but plane tickets, photos, and videos of the trip corroborate his account. Jasur says that he and Asia decided not to use the USB stick.And want this latest document made public. We traveled to Turkey to track down relatives of those listed in the document. Many hadn't heard news of their family in years.
Sınım bek yamandı, men yavaştım öyde. O havaldık mücezvattı onun.Men ancak beni bek urttu. Çok vakti beşkimiz kim talış. Ama bazen yine yakın adaş deklam, yakın adaş yani. Tük manatkan küllüktüm etkilek dini bir kadın uruşu. Yani keç oğan da, men mangan da ancak muşu sığınım yığlap bek.
Merhaba.
Merhaba.
Mademoiselle Isabel. Yaxşı məsələsi.
Yaxşı. Mən Türkiyəyə 2003-cü ili 1-ci ayının 9-cusuna gəldim. Toy qılğalı 15 il oldu.
I can tell that you're very nervous and you're shaking a little bit.
Ailemnin gibi çıxsılam hayacallanıb mı?
As you know, we've managed to get hold of a document. It has the name of Patim, who is your sister, I believe. Are you able to point out your sister's name for us? It's a lot of names on here.
Patim Mehmet Tohti. Minin sınnım. Tizimlikdiki numarı 358. 2018-ci ili 3-cü ayının 7-ci günü 4-cü lagırı kamalgan.
How does it feel seeing her name here?
Ödüklülən kürəşməgili 3-20 il oldu. Sınnımın. Sınnımını kürəb tizimlikdikini. Resmi bu. 8 yıl oldu bu resimli yolluğun.
She's beautiful. Did you know that she was in a camp?
Yok, bilmeydim.
Satellite imagery from 2018 shows the camp where Rosanisa's sister has likely been held. A sprawling prison-like facility, complete with wire fences and high walls.
How do you think that your sister has coped?
Bu gap kılmay turanmaydı bu. Biraz sakçı bir urup kılgan bolsa, meni nemiş urursa dep gap yandırıp, belki neç gün aç kalıp ya aclıktın ya susuzluktın.
The title of this whole document is people who have family members who have moved abroad and not come back. How does it feel knowing that because you've moved abroad, your family members may be under additional scrutiny?
Men şu vatandaki o Tayland'ın ki şu bizge ata anamızga şu işkence dep oyletme. Sen Türkiye'ye çıkıp dep şu ata anamızda işkence çektirip şu ulağalığa zulüm seliştim başka işemez dep oyletmiş.
In Patim's evaluation, the document states that her sister, Rosanisa, is in Turkey. But it also states that Patim shows good behavior and that it's recommended she graduates from the camp into community control. But that doesn't mean Patim is free. Further records obtained by a leading researcher on the camps, Dr. Adrian Zenz, also contain Patim's ID number. They show that in December 2018, she began 3 months of housekeeping training in the same facility. This lines up with reports of forced labor under the guise of vocational skills training. After that, we're unable to trace her movements. Others on the document fared even worse. We met with one man whose close family members were sentenced to many years in prison after training. He agreed to speak with us if we hid his identity, fearing the Chinese government's retaliation against his family.
What is it that you've heard or you know about these camps? Do you want revenge? Would you go to terrorist lengths to seek revenge? What is it you want the world to understand about the Uyghur experience?
Bunda zulümle kıyıversa elbette. Bunda zulümle bunda ziyankeşi uçuğu olan Adem'le elbette terörçülük yoluğa, terörçülük bana kalışı yapılıyor. Ben kalırdım. Çin hükümeti, Kıtay hükümeti hazır. Terörçülüğünü yoktu atmaydı, terörçülüğünü terbiye davadı. Terörçülük çıkıyordu. Yani siyahatım 아직 퇴출됐고 싶게 고맙습니다.